Hello, everybody.
Oh, it's nice to see you again. We're going to start with a bit of aerobics. I think Callie the clown? Callie the clown. Oh, sorry, Callie, I just called you a clown.
Oh, hello, everybody. Are we ready for some aerobics? Let's have everybody get up on your feet here. Everybody get up. And I'm going to go through the aerobics one time pretty quickly, and then we'll do it with some music. So our first action is our punches. We have slow motion punches and fast motion punches and slow and fast. You guys got that one? Okay, the next one is you're going to go down and jump up. Let me see it. Down and jump up. You guys got that one? The next one is you're going to jump forward, cross your arms, jump back, uncross your arms. So jump forward, cross, jump back, uncross. Jump forward, cross, jump back, uncross. And then next, you're going to climb, crawl forward like a tiger, and then dance party back. Forward like a tiger, dance party back. You will get to do freestyle, whatever kind of dance you want to do. It will be free. Let's hit it with some music.
My breath, scared to rock the boat and make a mess, so I said quietly, agreed politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, so I fell for everything. You held me down, but I got up, already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound, like thunder gonna shake the ground.
We are going to play a game.
That was fantastic. Joy, that was seriously good dancing. What we're going to do is we're going to play a game of Bring Me. So you'll need to be up on your feet, and it's the first one. In fact, I'll give you 5 seconds. And if you can bring it to me in the space of the time that I count to five, then you're a winner and you get a point for that round. Okay. The first one is, bring me something blue. 5, 4, 3. Wow, Olivia has already 2, 1. Finish, very, very nice. Boys, that is quite big, whatever you've just brought. Nice, and blue Lego, very good. Okay, put that down. Bring me something furry. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We've got a cat or a dog house. That is pretty furry. Oh, a lot of cat and dog stuff. Very nice. Use, I can't quite see what you've got. Annalisa's got a homemade crocheted blanket. She didn't do that in 5 seconds, I can tell you. All right, next one. Bring me something that begins, the name of the thing begins with the letter D. 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 It starts with that letter. 5, 4. Oh, dog! Wow! 2, 1. Oh, a picture of a dog. A book, a DVD. Very good. And an actual dog. And a, I can't quite see what the other things are. The dog, that is a winner. You get 2 points for that, Olivia. That was amazing. All right, bring me, you got 5 seconds. Hello, Lucy. You got 5 seconds to bring me something with the face of someone in your family on it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Very good. That was clever getting it up on your phone. Very nice. A picture of our whole church family. That's nice. Wow, lots of photos. Boys, I'm surprised you didn't just bring mum to the screen. Very good, or each other to the screen. Clever. Okay, this is the last one. Put those ones down. The last one is, I want you to bring me something which will make me laugh. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We've got a lot of funny faces going on there. That is good. Lucy, show me what you've got. A picture that you've colored in, or someone like colored in for you. It's pretty beautiful. And somebody's brought me a funny book with an iPhone in it. Fantastic. Joseph, you can stop the funny face, but it is a really good one. Okay, show me with your hands. How many points did each of you get? 3 points. 4 points for Joy. 10 points. There were not 10 points available. 10 points. Olivia got 5 and she did get lots because she got a double point for the dog. Fantastic. What we're going to do now is we're going to have the best bit of all. We're going to get to hear something from the Bible.
Great job on the game today, guys. You guys did really well, super quick. So this week we have been learning some different things that the Bible or God's word tells us about our situation. So we learned so far, can anyone remember some of the things we've learned thus far? I can see some people always talking about what God says to us when we're lonely, what God says to us when we're frustrated or grumpy or scared. And today we are going to learn about what God says for when you are bored. Liv, are you okay?
Annalise, I am so bored. I couldn't be more bored in my whole life if I tried. There's nothing to do here. Anything my mum tells me to do, I've done it already lots of times. It's so boring.
I can understand that. Most of us get bored sometimes. Children, I bet you get bored. Anything in there for people... when I'm a grown-up and I get bored, and I'm sure you guys get bored being stuck inside all day.
Annalise, you know before when you said that the Bible was God the Father's message to us, is there anything that he says in there for people who's bored like me?
Good question. Whatever he says always helps.
Well, Annalise, sorry, the doorbell's just gone. It's the Amazon delivery man. I think he's delivering some more caps for me. I've got to go. When I come back, will you tell me whatever it is that God says to bored people, yeah?
Sure. Children, God makes life an exciting adventure. Some people think God makes people boring or bored, and actually, it's quite the opposite. You know how in adventure stories, there's some hero or soldier that has to go on this huge adventure and he's fighting for a great king and he's wearing the king's armor and he goes to rescue people. Well, when we start to follow God, we immediately have this huge enemy to fight. That is the devil. And we get a good and great king to fight for. That's Jesus. Our King Jesus, he gives us his armor and the power to fight and win. And in the Bible, it actually says, be strong in the Lord and in his power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can fight against the devil's plans. That's an adventure. A new enemy, a king, a new power. So let me see those fingers. So the first thing we get is a new enemy because it's the devil. A new king, which is Jesus, and a new power, which is the armor of God.
I'm back! Right, you got anything for me? What's God say to me when I'm feeling bored?
Can anybody remember shouting it out? What can you tell? God makes life an exciting adventure because what? What is the first thing? We get a new enemy, that's right. And a new king, which is Jesus. And a new power, which is his power and the armor of God. Great job, Amelia.
Oh. Right, so like, you said that when I'm just doing normal things, then it can be like an adventure. Like, when I've finished playing with some toys and I don't know what to do next and I'm getting bored, and I can be like, right, what can I do now that my enemy the devil will hate and my King Jesus will love? Like I could clear up my toys really nice and maybe even clear up everything else in the house so that even if I didn't mess it up, and Jesus will like love that and the devil, he'll hate it.
Yeah, that's right. You definitely could do that. And, you know, for all the normal things that may seem boring, they could become a huge battleground when we think about the battle we're fighting against the devil for Jesus' sake. Shall we pray together? Let me see your fingers. Fold them together. Here we go. Father, thank you so much that you make life an adventure, that we get to serve you, our King, to fight against the devil, and you give us the power to win. Amen.
Amen. All right, thanks. I've got all sorts of things to do to go fight the devil. I've got to be off. See you later.
Bye, Liv. Well, we have come to the end of our time together. It has been so fun having you all with us today. Alice, can you give us an update on our photo challenge?
Yes. Every day, every week, we have a new challenge for you to take a photo and put it on Facebook, or to get an adult in your house to put it on Facebook. And then whoever gets the best, we will try and get a box of chocolates to you. Now, this week's photo challenge is farmyard. So we've already had quite a few people put in a photo of farmyard animals or fields or people who might be on a farm. So have a try taking a photo that you could be the animals, or you could take photos of animals. But we'll announce that on Sunday. And before that, we'll get to see you tomorrow at 4 if you can be with us. It's been lovely having you with us. Bye-bye.
Bye.